Good morning, everybody. Got a pretty good teaching this morning. Spirit truth number one, good doing. What is it? Do you know the two verses of Scripture in the one book? We're going to Titus, the second to the last letter written by Paul before his death. Outside of Rome, he was taken into captivity a second time. He went off the grid, and he could have fulfilled his statement about visiting Spain. So he could have made it to the east coast of Spain, to one or two cities, then back across Italy, to the west coast of Macedonia, where he wintered and called his students or disciples to him to give his last encouragement message. And there is a possibility that Paul lived to either side of 68 AD, 2 years before the temple was destroyed. So much for your history lesson. Titus, third chapter. Good doing, and foolish, foolish. Oh, you foolish Galatians, third chapter. 2,000 years ago, foolish was a heavy-duty, serious word. If you were called foolish, that was you were foolish and a great insult. Put them in mind to be subject to principalities and powers, to obey magistrates, to be ready for every good doing. I'm not a works guy. I'm not a James guy. I'm a number one good doing, in love, speaking truth with all that you meet, especially your neighbors. Okay? And love, speaking truth is the number one good doing. 3:2 of Titus, to speak evil of no man, to be no brawler, but gentle, showing all meekness unto all men. For we ourselves also were sometimes foolish. And then we got foolish down to 9. Disobedient, deceived. Eve was deceived by the serpent. Beguiled, deceived, serving diverse lusts of the flesh and pleasures, living in malice and envy, hateful and hating one another. Hating one another goes with foolish. But after that, the kindness and love, agape love, truth. The agape love is God's love. The kindness and love of God our Savior. Now here's a thought to be pondered. God our Savior in 3:4 of Titus. Christ our Savior. And you add Lord before Jesus. Lord Jesus Christ our Savior. God our Savior. What if God and the Lord Jesus Christ are the one and the same thing as far as salvation? Do I need to repeat that one? God our Savior towards men appeared. Life, life. Above Colossians, 3rd chapter. Above, above. Life, life. Appearing, appearing. In Rotherham's Emphasized Bible says, forth shining, in place of appearing. And here we have appeared at the end of verse 4. Verse 5, not by works of righteousness which we have done. That's why I'm the number one good doing, is in love speaking truth. I'm not a work preacher or teacher. And it is because of, I just read it there. Oh, not of works of righteousness, works of righteousness, which I have done, but according to his mercy, he hath saved us. How? I wrote how above saved us. God, our Savior, Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. And how did he save us? Here it comes. By the Lord's washing. Now, what is the Lord's washing? It's different from John the Baptist's washing. The Lord's washing is spiritual and on the inside. John the Baptist's washing was by water, the River Jordan, on the outside. Your clothes and your hair got wet. Well, that's why I had to write the song, Don't Judge a Book by Its Cover. God's looking at the mind, the heart, the inside, the condition of the spirit soul. One word, spirit soul. Only the word can divide or separate spirit soul. It's one word. Spirit soul in a body is two. A true witness. All right, the Lord's washing inside. So I added Lord's before washing and inside after washing. Of regeneration. Do you know what that word means? And renewal. Regeneration is renewing daily. It's a daily walk. It's a daily reading. Growing in the truth of the word daily. Did you get it? Renewing of the Holy Spirit, born sealed. Renewed of the Holy Spirit, born sealed. I added, it's not Holy Ghost, it's Holy Spirit of life, and you're born and you're sealed of the Holy Spirit, which he shed on us abundantly through the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior. We got God, our Savior, up in four, and the Lord Jesus Christ, our Savior, for a true witness in six. That being justified by his grace, justification is by the grace of God. His grace. Grace be. The last six plus one letters of Paul. Grace be in the very last verse. That is a major golden key to get many golden stars of study and understanding. Grace be. We should be made heirs. Now, joint heirs is only in the New Testament once, and you have to have two or more to start teaching. Well, fellow heirs. Okay, joint heirs, fellow heirs, both in the Bible. That's two, because they both end with the same word, heirs of an inheritance. And it speaks of the inheritance in Ephesians, Laodicea, and Colossians. I think you can find the word four or more times, locked in major doctrine, inheritance. So here we are to be made heirs according to the hope of eternal life. How do you spell eternal? Spiritually. E-T-E-R-N, capital E, capital L, with a dash underneath it. A short dash. There's 9 minutes. Let me get out here. Let me get to good doings and avoid foolish questions. That's what TikTokers are into, foolish questions. Mass confusion of men's minds, men's traditions and rituals. Churchism, denominationalism, division instead of love and unity. I'm going to leave it right there. You got maintain good doings instead of good works and avoid foolish questions in nine. All right, when I shall send over in 12, Tychicus. There it is, Nicopolis, he winters, 312 of Titus. Paul wintered in Nicopolis on the east coast of Macedonia, just above Achaia. Achaia, Athens, a Greek city. Macedonia is north of Achaia. Achaia is Greece. Love ya. Washed, born, sealed. The washing is inside the inner man. Regenerated, renewed in the Holy Spirit in 10 minutes and 20 seconds. You have a blessed day.